Jesus, after the baptism, he came out and started to pray. And three things happened. Number one, the heaven got opened. The second thing, he heard the voice of God from heaven, who Jesus is. The third is the identity of Jesus. Who is Jesus? Why has God sent him into the world? The mission of yours. So prayer basically brings three things to you. Check your prayer life. Are you really praying? Whatever may be type of prayer. See to it that your prayer, does it bear fruit? That when Jesus prayed, number one, heaven got opened. Number two, he heard the voice of God. You are my beloved son. And third, in you I am well pleased. Go on, move on with the life you are begun. Go ahead. The enemy is coming to attack you. I am with you. Go with the power of my spirit. Fight against the evil spirit and prove to the world that the one who is in you is stronger, greater, sufficient than the forces in the world. So the fourth is, you are sent through prayer. You are empowered to dispower, to disempower the evil spirit, to remove the power of the enemy. So your prayer is empowered. You are given the sword to cut the head of the enemy. You are given the boots to step over the head of the enemy. So prayer for Jesus was to see that I am part of heaven. So whenever you pray, the first thing comes to you, though you are on this earth, the heaven is becoming part of you. The heaven walks with you. The heaven guides you. So you are not left all alone on this earth. That's why in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 to 5, it is written, though we are on this earth, we cannot survive with the things that are available from the earth. We need the instruments of heaven to fight against the battle of the earth. Is it clear for you? I repeat for you because it's a very important word of God. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3 to 5. It's true that we are on this earth, but to handle the problems and situations of this earth, what the guidance and the instruments the world provides is not sufficient. So, to handle the situations of this earth or the problems of this earth, the heaven with its instrument has to be part of you. Only with a heavenly sword, with the heavenly boots, with the heavenly spear or helmet, you can conquer the earthly attacks of the enemy. So when Jesus prayed, number one, he realized he is not alone. The heaven got opened. The heaven is part of him. So wherever he goes, the heaven will accompany him. Heavenly power will accompany him. Heavenly anointing will accompany him. Heavenly source will be available for him. That the first revelation was given. So whenever you pray, you will get the revelation that you are not alone. We read in the book of Isaiah chapter 49, verse 14 onwards. They are praying, saying, crying, oh my God, you have left us and we are helpless. Our life has become full of problem. Where are you, Lord? Have you got eyes, Lord? Then next sentence, the Lord tells, how can a mother forget her little baby? Even if the mother forgets you, I will never forget you. I have written your name on the palm of my hands, and your walls are always before me. Whether you are worried about your protection or not, my eyes are always on your protection. You don't know. Your walls are always before me. That's what he said in 49 verse 15 onwards. Yes. So many of the time, we have to come to the truth. That is, when you pray, number one, you realize you are not alone. The heaven is part of you. Number two, when you pray, you hear the voice of God, and it is up to you to obey the voice of God to bear fruit. Jesus said in John 15:7, if you are in me and my word abides in you, you bear much fruit. If my voice is not guiding you, if you don't obey the voice, don't expect the fruit to be found in you. Okay, second, when Jesus prayed, what happened? Not only the heaven got open, he heard the voice. Number three, he was told who he is. What is his identity? You are not a person to fight on this earth. You are being sent as my beloved son. You are sent as my son, my daughter. What is your identity? You may be going through deep waters, but the water cannot drown you, because the one who called you is faithful. 1 Thessalonians 5:23-24. He will keep till that day your body, your spirit, and your soul, because our God is a faithful God. So when you go through burning flames, fire cannot burn you, for my hand will lead you. So in prayer, that's what was revealed to Manoa and his, when you move with, take care of your hair, take care of the working of God in you. The working of God in you is on four ways. Number one, you have to be aware that you are part of heaven. Number two, you hear the voice of God and you obey the voice of God. Number three, you are aware of who are you. What is your identity? Number four, with identity and power of God, you are sent to the world to fight against the enemy. That's why we read in Romans 16:20, God of peace, who abides in you, will soon crush the head of the enemy through your feet. God is not going to crush the feet by his feet. He is going to crush with your feet when he abides in you. When you are conscious of him abiding in you. So when will you be aware of it? So the hair that flows from the head, from Christ, the experience of the Holy Spirit, in these four ways, the Holy Spirit will be working in your life. Whenever you pray to the Holy Spirit, number one, the Holy Spirit will teach you that you are part of heaven. Heaven is with you. Number two, whenever you are anointed with the Holy Spirit, you will hear the voice of God and he will prompt you to obey the voice of God. Number three, whenever you are filled with the Holy Spirit, your identity, you may go through problem. Some people may say that I want to finish you off. Let them tell anything. But who are you to your God? You will know. What God wants to do through you, why does he allow this problem in your life? God doesn't send problems for you, darkness around you, to destroy you, but that you may lift up your light and dispel the darkness. Amen. That's why the Lord says in the book of Isaiah 60:1-2, the whole world is lying in darkness, and the people of this world are covered with thick darkness, but upon you my light will shine. Amen. Carry this light to this dark world. So the fourth thing the Lord spoke to Manoa is, move from inside to out, not from outside to in. The Lord is telling Manoa, and then later time, the son who was born for them, Samson, when Samson had so many internal desires, and without realizing the voice of God, without hearing the voice of God, without discerning the voice of God, without obeying the voice of God, now Samson goes and gets married. Some people come and tell, Father, I love that girl because she's very good to me, Father. Though she's a non-Christian, she's too good, Father. She says she will be with me, Father. And without her, Whenever I pray, only she is coming. I said, that is a sign that she is not coming. No, Father, you pray that somewhat God changes his mind. You create your own desires and you want God to tell that it is God's desire. Sorry, it doesn't happen like that. You get satisfied, you get married, the next day, first day garland, next day hit on the head. And the third day hit on the feet, you can't get out of your bed. Fourth hit on the eyes, all tears. Take care, you hear the voice of God properly. That's why the Lord said, you don't go to the problem. Samson was going through problem that the girl whom he married went away from him. It's a terrible problem. You got married, within a month, the wife has gone away. Still worse, your wife is given to your friend. You are humiliated. You have lost. These are part of life. When you don't move with heaven, when you don't obey the voice of God, when you don't remind yourself of who are you to your God, when you don't move with the power of God to destroy the enemy around you, the enemy will be part of you. Until you destroy the enemy around you, the enemy will be found around you.